Breaking news involving longtime Trump stooge Roger Stone, who is now alleged, according to a report by Mediaite, to have told an NYPD officer to abduct and punish a prosecutor that was involved with the Mueller investigation. So here is what is being alleged as of right now. This takes place back in December of 2020. Stone was at that time working on the effort to overturn the election. In audio from that time reviewed by Mediaite, Stone can be heard at his Florida condo speaking with Sal Greco, who is an NYPD officer and served as security for Stone. So Greco would soon after that be fired by the NYPD for his ties to Roger Stone. So that didn't work out well for him, but let's focus on what happened before he was canned. In the audio, the pair discuss Aaron Zelinsky, a prosecutor who served as a deputy to former special counsel Robert Mueller and who led the case against Stone. Stone in the audio tells Greco, he needs to be punished. You have to abduct him and punish him. That has to be done. It will be easy to abduct him because he is a weakling. So look, the content of that, horrifying. The way that it's delivered, characteristically Batman villain. Original live action television series, to be clear. But anyway, Roger Stone was asked about this and both he and Greco deny what the Mediaite report reveals. Roger Stone said, and this is his defense, you must have been subjected to another AI generated audio track. I never said any such thing. Okay. A source familiar with conversations between Stone and Greco said, he talked many times about the election not going our way. They're going to steal it. We have to be prepared to get straight to the violence. That was his theme, get to the violence. He didn't think Trump would win. He was pushing for violence because he thinks the entire system is rigged. And they also said that Roger Stone holds a vendetta forever. Aaron Zelinsky is top of his list. So his defense is, hey, it's AI generated. And I have been warning since the beginning of AI sort of coming to popular consciousness here and saying that the issue with these deep fake videos being released is not just the fake videos that are made. It is the fact that fake videos are made. So real videos and audio tracks can simply be claimed as, yeah, it's probably one of those. There's no way to prove it. I don't know how you would prove that this audio was original, perhaps the fact that it comes from 2020 before a lot of these tools were available, but it is a very easy thing to hide behind and hard to disprove. We kind of just have to go with what we know of Roger Stone. And look, this certainly seems to fit in with his behavior, although that of course is not proof. Jackson, what do you make of this?
Yeah, I mean, it's right in line with something that Roger Stone would do, a guy who has Richard Nixon tattooed on his backside and basically revels in the brand of I'm here to cause trouble. But like you pointed out, and it's a good point, you can always hide behind the fact that AI technology is what it is now. Even if public opinion is completely against you, even if everybody, kind of figures that you actually said something, you can always hide behind it. But another thing too is that unless law enforcement really wants to go after you, sometimes people can hide behind their brand of being just low down individuals. For instance, like Donald Trump's a good example. Like we're so overexposed to all the stuff that he said and all the things that he's done that it's just kind of like another Tuesday, another Wednesday. So Roger Stone's kind of the same. Like hearing that he mentioned something along these lines, it's like, oh, it's just another thing for Roger Stone. It kind of doesn't draw that much interest other than original conversation. But hey, it is what it is.
Well, note to self, blame it on AI. We're right. Not blaming it on interns anymore. We're gonna blame it on AI.
Exactly.
The moral of the story. No, I mean, seemingly, and we are all being very clear, what seems to be true may not necessarily be true. It hasn't been absolutely proven. However, yes, Roger Stone has a modus of operandi. And does this seem like this is something he would say and do? I mean, they were inebriated with power. We know that there's a saying that absolute power corrupts absolutely. And absolutely, we know that Roger Stone and many others swirling around the Trump camp are and were corrupt. Is it out of pace with Roger Stone's MO that he would say something like that to a member of law enforcement? No. Is it shameful if he did do it? Yes. Because to believe that they would abuse power in that way to say these people got to be dealt with, they got to be dealt with violently. And let's make sure one of these people come up missing. I mean, that's a whole lot of audacity right there.
Yeah, 100%. By the way, look, because I'm, you know, the host, I think I should be first to apologize for the B-roll that was played during that. Clearly, our producers had AI generated images of Roger Stone wearing absolutely ridiculous sunglasses. I apologize to Mr. Stone. I know that you would never, obviously, you wouldn't wear those glasses out and about. We are using Midjourney to generate the images. See, we can do it with anything.
Roger Rabbit. What's the villain's name from Roger Rabbit?
100%, and that was Christopher Lloyd. Roger Stone wishes he was Christopher Lloyd. But anyway, Roger Stone has been caught saying similar things before. He was previously caught on video making violent remarks around the 2020 election, saying, "F the voting, let's get straight to the violence, shoot to kill," he was recorded saying the day before the election by a documentary crew. Stone claimed those videos were fake as well. This was a documentary crew that he was allowing to embed with him. He said it to them and then just claimed after the coup was unsuccessful and they did not have control of the United States that it was fake. It's a garbage defense. It's not intended to persuade, it's intended to muddy the waters a little bit. And I would remind everyone that like the fact that there's going to be this easy proliferation of AI generation for text, video, audio, the multimodal, the integration of all those things, it might seem like, oh, that's bad for everybody. But is it actually bad for everybody? Is it bad for the left and for the right? Who thinks that people gradually growing to be able to trust even less the things they hear and see and read on the internet might lead to universal healthcare or free public college? Who thinks those sorts of things will be the political results of increasing misinformation, disinformation, and people, you know, voting and choosing candidates based on utter nonsense? No, it is chaos that will be produced by that. And chaos benefits those who are already winning. It benefits the status quo. And so those who've already written the tax code the way they like it, that already have a Congress that can't function, if it's so hard to challenge that because you can't organize, it's so easy to take down actual insurgent candidates by generating insane videos of them. I think that this very much is going to be yet another tool used by those who are already powerful, already wealthy, already in political power to make sure that there's no effective challenge to their power. And when they are caught doing absolutely reprehensible things, saying reprehensible things, it's an easy evasion as well. And for people like us, it's not going to be convincing. But what right winger isn't going to instantly buy that Roger Stone didn't actually say that, that it was AI? And fundamentally, they don't care because they want people in Trump's orbit to be saying things like this. So that's my fear. Nina, what do you think about this? Any disagreement?
No, I agree with you. It just reminds me of the Wizard of Oz, the theme there. You know, don't pay attention to the man behind the curtain. Mm-hmm. That's what this really is about.
More flat earthers. That's what's going to happen with the AI revolution. A lot of good things will come from it, but you know, it's pros and cons with everything. So I guess it's good that we're aware of what could go wrong this early in the game. You know what I'm saying? Like versus social media, there's a lot of good things, but like in the 15 years or so that apps blew up, now we got all this metadata we're looking back on like, oh, we kind of got to go outside and have real relationships. So at least we're on top of it early.
Hey, thanks for watching the video. We really appreciate it, guys. And we appreciate it if you become members because that allows us to be independent, honest, progressive, all the things that you don't get from corporate media. And all of that is because of you guys. Hit the join button below and become one of us. Become a Young Turk.